Hello students, this is Taranam Jahan and I'm here with you all to start the new chapter from economics. So here this is a chapter 1 from your economics development. Here in this chapter you will find answers to many questions such as what should a country be like? What are the essential things that we require? Can life be better for all? How should the people live together? Can there be more equality? The answers to all these questions are not found only in economics but also in history and political science. But this is because the way we live today is influenced by the past. So here in this chapter, we are going to discuss about how the life of the people is influenced with the help of development. So under this chapter, we are going to cover up the certain points, that is what is development. We'll also see the income and the other goals of the people. We'll see what is national development. Then we see that how we are going to compare the different countries and the state, whether they are developed or undeveloped countries. Income and the other criteria we are going to see. Public facilities which have been provided through which we can say that the country is a developed one. Then we'll see the sustainability development. Now before starting up this chapter, we should know what is development. Development is nothing but something better than before. Each one of us have different goals to be set which will be termed as development. Different people can have different developmental goals. So what may be the developmental goal for one may not be a development for the other person. It may be even a destructive for the other person. How it can be a destructive for the other person, we'll discuss one by one. So this is how we start with the definition of the development. It is nothing but something better than before. Now let's see how the different people can have different developmental goals. So the first is labor. What does the labor wants? The labor wants the development in a way so that their wages are increased. Increase in the wages for a labor is a development for them. In the same manner, for a child, a development is going to the school rather than going to a factory for a working as a child labor. And for the prosperous farmer, assured high family income through a higher support prices for the crop is a development for them. So in this way, different people are having a different developmental goals. Now we have seen that different people are having different developmental goals. In what way? Through the labor, child and a prosperous farmer. So now we got to know that the different people can have different developmental goals and maybe a development for other can be a destructive for someone. Now how it can be a destructive for someone? Because like if a government is constructing a dam, it is very good for the people that are residing in the urban areas, as the problem of water and electricity scarcity is solved. But if we see on the other side, that is the people residing near to the dam or on the land where the dam is constructed, it is not good for them as they have to shift themselves from there. So it is a destructive for the other person. In that way, we can say that yes, the developmental goals may not be a development for other, it can be a destructive for someone else. Income and other goals. Development depends on two important concepts, that is material things and non-material things. Now what is material things? Material things are nothing but money, car, house, etc. Without money, other things are impossible to have as such much as they can earn in development. Whereas non-material things are nothing but the freedom, equality, respect, etc., which can be earned without money. This non-material things, this has to be earned by a person with their moral character. In some cases, these may be more important than income because material goods are not all that you need to live. So with the previous discussion, we come to the conclusion that money or a material things that one can buy with it is one factor on which our life depends. However, the quality of our life also depends on non-material things such as equal treatment, freedom, security, and respect for others. So for development, people look at a mix of goals. The developmental goals are not only about better income, but also about other important things in the life. That is, as I said, they want the treatment, better treatment, freedom, security, respect, not only income, even all these things. So it is a mixture of certain material and non-material things. Then only we can have a proper development in the country. Now, how we say that we have earned the national development? What is national development? National development refers to the ability of the nation in order to improve the standard of living of their population. Standard of living of the citizen depends upon what? The per capita income. If the person is earning more, then he will definitely, the country will have the proper per capita income. So the standard of living of the citizen depends upon the per capita income, gross domestic product, their literacy rate, availability of the health of that country, how many clinics and the hospitals are there, education, whether the people are going for a child labor or whether the children are around the age of 6 to 14 years are going to the school, they are having a proper education or not. The literacy rate will calculate. According to all these things, all these factors are being considered to know the national development of the country. So this is what is called as a national development, where we calculate the per capita income, gross domestic product, literacy rate, availability of the health, etc. These all measurements are in term is called as an improvement of the country or a development of the country. Now, how to compare different countries or a state as per their income? How do we come to know that the state or a country is a developed one? How do we come to know it is underdeveloped but still a developing country? See, income is a most important factor of development. Without income, there is no development. So to compare countries, their income is considered to be the one of the most important attributes. Countries with higher income are more developed than the countries those who are earning less income. As different countries are having different population, comparing the total income will not tell us what an average person earns, because there is a fluctuating in the population when we compare it with the other countries. Might be in some country more population, might be in the other country there is a less population. So we don't come to the conclusion of the average person's, what is an average person's earning. So we compare the average income of the country with a formula. Now, what is a formula in order to calculate the average income? It is nothing but total income of the country divided by total population of the country. So when we divide the total income with the total population of the country, we get per capita income. That is per head the income earned by the person. So per capita income is calculated when we divide total income of the country with total population of the country. So till now we have seen the definition of the development and the concept of the development that depends upon the two things, that is material and the non-material, and the how development can be achieved. But we always talk about the developed countries, underdeveloped countries, or a developing country. How do we come to know this, that this country is a development, this country is an underdevelopment? How we come to know? So now let us see that how do we come to know which country is developed and developing and underdeveloped. How we compare? We compare them with their incomes. So how we compare with them, with their incomes? Let's see. Now let's see how do we come to know that the so-and-so country is the richest country and so-and-so country is the low-income country. It is nothing but with the help of the World Development Report. Now, how this report has been made? With the help of the per capita income that have been issued by the each country. Now, how the per capita income is calculated? That is nothing but the total income of the people divided by the total number of the population will give you the per capita income. So according to the per capita income, the World Development Report issues and report which specifies the richest and the low income country. So for that, they have a certain standard amount. According to that amount, they calculate whether they are the richest one or the low income country. Now what is that standard amount which has been specified by the World Development Report? So according to the World Development Report of 2017, they have said that the countries whose per capita income is equivalent or more than the US $12,056 is called as the richest country. And whoever's income, that is whichever countries is having the per capita income of around $955 or less than this is termed to be called as the low income country. Obviously, example, India. Now let us have a look at this table. We have taken two countries A and B, and we have supposed the population of these countries is only 5% each. And we have calculated the average per capita income on the basis of that. We have totaled it, then divided by the 5 number, that is only 5 per person living in that country, and we got the average per capita income. Now when we compare this per capita income, what do we get to know by this? See, the per capita income is quite identical because there's no much difference. It is just 8,200, and under the B country we are having 10,000. But still, where do we prefer to live? If we want to go for a job or if we want to migrate to any other country like A and B, where do we want to go first? Though the per capita income of A is less, but still we want to prefer to go for a country A, not B. Why? Because A is preferred. Why A is preferred? Because it has more equitable distribution. If you see the equitable distribution of the income, the person is neither too rich, neither too poor. They are so-so. They are earning properly. So here, because if we see the earnings of these people, the five people, we will prefer A country rather than the B country, though the per capita income of A is less than compared to the B. Because why? In a B, we see the most of the citizens in the country B are very poor. They are earning only 500, and only one person is extremely rich. Hence, while average income is useful for comparison, it does not tell us how this income is distributed among the people. So when we are calculating the per capita income, we just don't calculate the disparities that has been being placed in that country while giving an income to the person. So here, if you see the country, there is a disparity in the distribution of the income. So there, most of the people, that is 90% of the population, is earning 500 over here. Only one person is earning 48,000. So there is a disparity in the distribution of the income. But still, on that basis, we calculate the per capita income and we give the result of the poor country and the rich country. But here, this is a demerit actually. So when we compare this both the countries, though the per capita income of B is more, but still we will prefer to go to the country A for a job because there is an equal distribution somewhere, so quite equivalent distribution of the income. The people are there, not neither very poor not very rich. Equal distribution we can find there. So we will definitely prefer for the country A rather than the country B because there are more number of the people, that is 90% of the people are earning only 500 rupees over there. That means there is certain disparities over there in the income. Might be they are not very good at freedom, might be they are not having much of security, might be there is a discrimination on the color basis or a caste basis. So here we come to the conclusion that only money is not important. Even these things, that is the non-material things, are also important in order to select the country to earn. So all these things are taken into consideration when we say that the country is a developed country or an underdeveloped country. So there are many examples, like if we compare with India and USA, though USA is ready to pay you 1 crore of rupees for a job, but still you will opt to stay in India and work for 60 lakh. Why? Because in USA you have a racial discrimination, you have a disparities over there. But in India we have all security, freedom, we can earn, we can live quietly with a secured life. We have a secured life in India than compared to the USA. So we'll definitely prefer to stay back in a USA and earn less than compared to the USA, because we want the freedom, security, respect too. So here we come to the conclusion that money is not everything. People see various others or factors also in order to migrate or to earn their livelihood or to earn the better income. They not only see the income, they see even other non-material things. So with this, we come to this conclusion. Income and other criteria. There are many countries where we find that their per capita income to be more than $12,056 per US dollar per year, but still they lag behind in freedom, security, respect, etc. For that, they are not counted in the list of developed countries. Example, Middle East countries. Now let us compare our three states. What are those? Haryana, Kerala, and Bihar. Now, what is the per capita income as per your textbook 2015-16? It has been given. Haryana is earning 1,62,034 rupees. Kerala is earning 1,40,190 rupees. And Bihar is earning 31,454 rupees as a per capita income. This is the ratio given for 2015 and 16. So with this, we'll come to the conclusion that the money is not everything. So we will also compare health and education. If the per capita income were to be used as a measure of the development, then Haryana will be considered the most developed country because it is having the best per capita income than compared to the other two countries or other two states, sorry, the Bihar and the least developed state. Bihar is the least developed one out of those three. However, this is not true. If we look at the other criteria, if we go for other criteria, that is nothing but the freedom, security, respect, we see that the Kerala is the first one, the best country. It is having a good medical facility. For that, we have to look at the IMR. So according to that, if we see the other criteria, Kerala is coming on the first. If we calculate the IMR, that is infant mortality rate. So according to that, if we calculate, Kerala is on the first, then second Haryana, then third Bihar. But here, as per the per capita income, which has been calculated, Haryana is on the top, Kerala on the second, and Bihar is on the third. So we cannot say that the measuring of the development on the per capita income is the correct way, because if we see the other criteria, that is non-material things, if we see on that basis, if the developed countries has been calculated, then the result will come totally different. So we come to the conclusion that money is not everything. So we have to compare the other criteria too, that is health and education, while calculating the developed countries. So in order to know the development of the country on the base, not only on the basis of income, but also on the basis of the other criteria, then we have to calculate on the basis of IMR. IMR is nothing but the infant mortality rate. Now what does the infant mortality rate means? This indicates the number of children that die before the age of 1 year per 100 births. So now let us compare per 1000 IMR. Here on the table, if we see that as per the report given by the 2013-2014, if we see the Haryana, how many people died? that is 33, and the literacy, and in Kerala 10, and in Bihar more, that is 38. So, but still, Haryana is on the top on the basis of the income of the country. But if we see the infant mortality rate, Kerala is having the less infant mortality rate than compared to the Haryana. And Bihar is having no doubt more infant mortality rate. But comparatively, if we see the Haryana and Kerala, Kerala should be on the top if we see the other criteria in order to calculate the developed country. So here, then if we see the literacy rate as per 2011, data given in your textbook. So if we see the literacy education that has been given to these countries, Haryana is having a literacy rate around 82%. Kerala again leading on the top with 94% of the literacy rate, whereas in Bihar it is less than compared to the other two countries, that is 62%. So again, on the literacy basis, Kerala should be on the top, but as per the income, we are taking Haryana as a developed country. But if we compare the other criteria, on that basis, Kerala is on the top. So the net attendance ratio per 100 person, if we see how many people are attending the school, the number of children, those who are attending the schools, those who are having an education facilities over there. So if we compare again with the Haryana, Kerala and Bihar, Haryana is having 61% of the net attendance ratio. The children, those who are attending the school. So 61% of the children are attending the school in Haryana state, whereas in Kerala, 83% of the children are attending schools in Kerala. Whereas in Bihar, it is less than compared to the other two countries. But if we see the other criteria of all the three, that is literacy rate, infant mortality rate and net attendance, the other non-material things, if we calculate about this, then on this basis, Kerala should be on the top. But according to the per capita income that has been earned by the states, according to that, Haryana is on the top. So here with this, we can see the difference between how the development is calculated on the per capita basis. But the development should be calculated not only on the basis of income, but also on the basis of the non-material things. Then only we can come to the correct decision of calling that country as a developed country. We cannot say the country is developed until and unless the country is developed in all these three situations, that is literacy rate, infant mortality rate and net attendance ratio. If these things are perfect, then only we can call the country as a developed country. It's nothing but the table comparison which we have done already. You just compare this with the different states, that is you are having Haryana, Kerala and Bihar, what is the infant mortality rate, what is the literacy rate, the same comparison which we have already discussed. Public facilities. Facilities which are provided by the government is considered as a public facility, like schools, hospitals, community halls, transport, electricity, etc. Now, as we know that though Haryana has more income than the average person in Kerala, but still Kerala has a low infant mortality rate because of the better public system like public distribution system, health and nutritious status to the state. How? So see, we have seen the per capita income of the Haryana was very high than compared to the Kerala and Bihar, compared to the other these two states. But why still the Kerala is having a good, less mortality rate, good education facilities? Why all this? Because it has adequate clinics and hospitals. It has good PDS system, good quality of food is being distributed, might be. That is the reason why the people are not falling ill over there. It has a good adequate schools and colleges, might be. That is the reason why the literacy rate is high than compared to the Haryana. So this is what the public facilities is. So all this, it is our duty. It is our duty to improve the things like education, health, etc. So for this, we should all come together to achieve the greater goal. This is nothing but the public facility. We need public facility because we are not able to purchase all things by money. We cannot able to buy a pollution-free environment with the help of money. It is our duty to achieve that goal. We have to have a pollution-free environment. So how we have to do our duties? Consume less oil, petrols, cars. We can go by a walk. So with that, there are many certain things through which we can control our environment pollution. So whose duty is this? It is a duty of public. So in order to achieve all the better development goals, we have to come forward. Human Development Index is nothing but HDI. HDI rank is calculated on the basis of country's development. Apart from the development, they also see the per capita income, literacy rate, life expectancy, etc. All this is calculated in order to know the Human Development Index of that country. According to the Human Development Index, India's life expectancy is 68 years. Now let's see this table. It has been calculated in order to know the Human Development Index than compared to the other countries. Now if we see the comparison, it is quite surprising that Sri Lanka, which is the smallest neighborhood of India, is much developed than compared to our big country like India. Now if you see the per capita income in US dollar, Sri Lanka is earning more than India. Though our country is the biggest in terms of even the territorial land, if we calculate, even then Sri Lanka is on the top earning the per capita income more than India and the other countries too. Even the life expectancy is proper over there, 74 years. And then compared to the India, only 64 years life expectancy of Indian people are. And if you see the literacy rate, 91% of the people are literates over there. And India is having only 61% of a literacy rate. And if you see the gross enrollment ratio out of three levels, if we see again, Sri Lanka is on the top then compared to India, though we are territorially and even in the population base, we are the highest then compared to the Sri Lanka, but still. And world's Human Development Index rank, you see, Sri Lanka is holding 93rd rank and India is holding 126th rank, Myanmar is holding 130th rank and Bangladesh is at the last holding 137th rank, Nepal 138th rank. So the lowest rank is held by the Sri Lanka, that is 93% on the top. So with this we can come to the conclusion that Sri Lanka is better and the people in Sri Lanka are more healthy, educated. The Human Index Development rank is even on the top for Sri Lanka. So till now we have seen the definition of the development and the concept of the development that depends upon the two things, that is material and the non-material, and the how development can be achieved. But we always talk about the developed countries, underdeveloped countries or a developing country. How do we come to know this, that this country is a development, this country is an underdevelopment? How we come to know? So now let us see that how do we come to know which country is developed and developing and underdeveloped. How we compare? We compare them with their incomes. So how we compare with them, with their incomes, let's see.